locks and doors were barred, and all the windows fastened. I spent the night in sleeplessness, and rose with every sound. I had to go for sorrow, and half in fear the day would find the soldiers parading through to drag us all away. And just before the sunrise, I heard something at the wall. The gate began to rattle, and a voice began to call. I hurried to the window, looked out into the street, expecting swords and torches, and the sound of soldiers' feet. There was no one there but Mary, so I went down to a hurry. John stood there beside me as she told us where she'd been. She said they moved him in the night, and none of us knows where. The stone's been rolled away, and now his body isn't there. So we both ran to the garden, then John ran on ahead. We found the stone, an empty tomb, just the way that Mary said. But the winding sheet they wrapped him in was just an empty shell. And how or where they're taking him was more than I could tell. Something strange had happened there, just what I did not know. John believed a miracle, but I just turned to go. Circumstance and speculation couldn't have led me on, cause I'd seen them crucify him. And then I saw him die. Back inside the house again, the guilt and anguish came. Everything I promised him just added to my shame. When at last it came to choices, I denied I knew his name. And even if he was alive, it could never be the same. But suddenly, the air was filled with strange and sweet perfume. For me, with his eyes held open wide, and I fell down on my knees, and I just cried. And then he raised me to my feet, and as I looked into his eyes, I was shining.